Today in this video, we will know about the sag in the transmission line. In this video, we will focus on the topic as what is sag, what are the factors affecting sag and calculation of sag. First question is what is sag? For safety purpose, the ground clearance of the conductors of maximum temperature and minimum loading condition should be maintained. So the analysis of the sag and tension is important in transmission line for the continuity and quality of electrical services. The depth of conductor between the two level supports is called sag, or the vertical distance between the highest point of the electrical pole and the lowest point of the conductor between the two adjacent level supports is known as sag. If the tension of the conductor is increased beyond the limit, it may get broken and the power transmission of the system get erupt. So the analysis of sag is very important in transmission line. Second question is, what are the factors affecting the sag? First one is conductor weight. Sag of the conductor is directly proportional to its weight. Second, span. Span is the horizontal distance between the two electrical supports. Sag is directly proportional to the square of the span length. So longer span gives more sag. Third one is tension. Sag is inversely proportional to the tension in the conductor. Higher tension increases the stress in the insulators and supporting structures. Fourth one is wind. Wind effect increases sag in the inclined direction. And the last affecting factor is temperature. The sag is reduced at low temperature and it increases at higher temperature. So these are the main factors affecting the sag. Now we will see calculation of sag. In an overhead line, the sag should be so adjusted that tension in the conductors is within safe limits. So the sag calculation is very much needed. We shall now calculate the sag when supports are at equal levels. Consider a conductor between two equilevel supports A and B with O as the lowest point. Lowest point will be at the midspan. Here L is length of span, W is weight per unit length of conductor, T is the tension in the conductor. Here consider a point P on the conductor. Taking the lowest point O as the origin, let the coordinates of point P be X and Y. That curvature is so small, so consider it's equal to its horizontal projection, that is OP is equal to X. So the forces acting on the portion OP are, first one is the weight WX of conductor acting at a distance X by 2 from O. Second is the tension T acting at O. Now equating the moments of two forces, TY is equal to WX into X by 2. That is, Y is equal to WX square upon 2T. The maximum sag is represented by the value of Y. For example, at support A, X is equal to L by 2. So sag is equal to W L by 2 square divided by 2T is equal to W L square divided by 8T. So here is the calculation of sag when supports are at equal levels.